Sunita, that was wonderful. It's so powerful. It's so powerful. And, you know, whoa, looking at the video, the imagery in it is incredibly striking. It's very bold visually. And that was your idea. Just can you tell us what gave you that idea?
So come up with this idea wasn't that hard for me because I was living it and I exactly knew what I wanted to be in my music video. And I had friends who had bruises on their faces because of fighting to escape child marriage. And I think this is a real face of force and child marriage.
And so let's talk a little bit more about that. I think that 15 million girls a year are being forced into child marriage. So just while I take a drink of water, tell me a little about the experience that you saw. What does it mean day to day? What is the problem with child marriage as you experienced it with your friends?
The problem of...
Mm-hmm. With the child marriage, you talked about seeing your friends with bruises on their faces. What kind of lives are they leading?
So they had to forget their dreams and they have to escape going to a school. And at age 15 and 16, they should be old women and raising children at even they young. And their bodies cannot handle it. And they are staying play with dolls. And they're forced to forget their dreams and what they want to be in the future. Mm-hmm. And sometimes they don't have supporters.
And we're going to talk about dreams later because they're very important to you. But so let's just take a step back. I mean, you were born in and raised in Herat in Afghanistan.
Yes.
Under the Taliban. And so that is a very difficult life to lead. And your family fled Afghanistan and eventually ended up in Iran. That's right, isn't it? Now, I was just very struck. I just wanted to take a moment here by what Alexander was saying. His presentation was so powerful in helping us to reframe the narrative around the refugee story. But I'm also very keen, in a way, to try and get beyond the label of refugees for huge groups of individual people. It's a kind of othering when we talk about refugees, as if they were a homogenous, monolithic group of people. And so with Sunita, I want to talk to you as an artist and an activist and someone with power and agency. But it's true that when you left Afghanistan for Iran, you were a refugee. Can you tell me a little about life in Iran? What were you doing?
So we left Afghanistan to escape the Taliban. We went to Iran just to find a shelter to survive. And the life wasn't easy. And at that moment, my wish was to go to a school because I was a legal refugee. I couldn't go to a school. I didn't have any paper or ID. And I started my first grade in a school, in a mosque, to learn how to write and read because it was my dream to read. And it was very hard because I had to hide my identity and, yeah.
Because the life of a refugee in another country, as we saw from Alexander, is difficult. Often the host country does not want people it sees as interlopers. So how did you support yourself? What were you doing in Iran? What kind of jobs?
I was cleaning at two different places, mm-hmm, to support myself. And then I went to an NGO to take classes because I couldn't go to real school. Mm-hmm. And also I was learning karate.
You were learning karate?
Yeah, I needed.
Okay, I'm just going to sit slightly further back. but having no papers is difficult. I think we have a clip. Our first clip just shows a little bit of you in the classroom. Let's take a look at the first clip.
اینو نصف میکنی؟ یکیش مثلا میشه شناسنامه واقعی، درسته؟
درست.
یکی میشه اونی که دوست داریم باشی. اسمتون دوست دارین چی باشه؟ فامیلتون نام، پدرتون چی باشه؟ نام مادرتون چی باشه؟ محل تولدتون کجا باشه؟ قبوله؟ سونیتا یعنی چی؟
سونیتا یعنی پرستو.
پرستو. چرا جکسون؟
من اونجا دیگه خارجی میشه.
همین؟ خارج بودن خوبه؟
نه با اون پدر مادره چیزی که بسید.
مایکل جکسون و ریانا؟
میگونه خانمش چیه خانم؟
میدونم. مثلا نمیدونم هم نسل هستن یا نه؟
حالا اشکال نداره.
اشکال نداره.
So I couldn't help noticing that your fantasy name was Jackson.
Your last name is Jackson.
My last name is Jackson. And on behalf of all Jacksons, I would like
to prove it.
I don't have my papers. I would like to give you permission to use the name Jackson. If you would like to be Sonita Jackson, that would give me great pleasure.
Thank you.
But what does it mean not to have papers?
For me, it means when you don't have paper, means you don't exist.
Yeah. So it's about identity, in a way.
I made a passport for myself. Just I wanted to have an identity. Even it wasn't a real passport, but I was happy to have something I created.
And we're getting a sense of you as you know, we've heard your rap and seen your video, and now you're making a passport. We're getting a sense of you as a creative person. You're an artist. But as you are in Iran and you're working and you're cleaning bathrooms and you're studying to read and write as you can, life is hard enough, but then something else happens in your family. Can you tell me what that was? It was a big decision.
So I was in Iran, and my mom, she came from Afghanistan to take me to Afghanistan because my brother, he wanted to get married, and my family didn't have money to pay for his wife. My mother needed a price for me to pay for my brother's wife, and it is a tradition.
So your mother needed to sell you in order that your brother could pay for his wife. Right. Let's have a look at another clip, and then we'll talk a bit more about that.
خب سنیتا بگفتی رو رزی کرده؟
نه، رزی میشه.
اگر از این اشاره از این اشاره برای میاد دوباره.
So as we look at your face there, I'm trying to imagine what you must have been thinking as you heard this.
I wasn't angry at my mom. I was angry at that situation and society. And I was thinking to find a solution. What should I do to escape child marriage or forced marriage?
I think it's very important what you just said, that you weren't angry at your mother. Can you say a bit more about that?
Some people, it is hard for some people to understand that. I love my mother and I'm not mad at her because it is not her fault. And she loves me, she cares about me. If she tried to sell me because she didn't know another way. Sometimes the society and traditions won't let you to make a different decision. And I have to make that clear that parents love their daughters and they just stuck in old traditions and they know to new ways, new possibilities for their daughters. And yeah, thank you.
I think as we sit here, with fierce compassion as the theme of the forum, I think that what you are showing and helping us to understand is being compassionate for people with a very different set of traditions and values and culture. But we still have to find a way of changing that system. So I wondered, you know, there's you and you're young and there are no role models for how to get out of this situation for you. And you love your family, but they want you to do this thing. So how do you even begin to think differently? How do you begin to think about how you might make change?
I didn't have any role model, but I knew that I wanted to change my life. And I had to make that vision for myself in my mind. So I create a model for myself. And I told myself, close your eyes and see where do you want to be in the future. I imagined a better life for myself and better future. And I believe in my dreams. And I worked very hard for them to get here.
So it was around this time that you made the video that we just saw, that you made the work Brides for Sale, as an expression really of your feelings. It's a wonderful thing to do, and you know, we at Sundance really value the freedom of creative expression, and you were using your imagination and your art to say something, and say it not just to your family, but to say it to and on behalf of lots of other people. But you're in Iran. Tell me about what it is to make music as a woman in Iran, and how Iran looks on rap.
It was very dangerous for me to become a rapper because women in Iran, they're not allowed to sing. And government, they don't like, especially rap, because you have to tell something the truth. And when I came to the US, I realized they were looking for me. Yeah, and because of that, because I'm a rapper, the woman who taught me how to make dreams book, she got fired.
Let's stop there for a second, because I do want to show a clip on the about the dream book. We'll understand what that is. But just on rap, why did you choose rap to express yourself?
Exactly. At first I chose pop music, uh-huh. but because I couldn't fit all my words in pop music, it could be a 30-minute song. So then I tried rap, and I realized it's the best way. I can tell more, I can share important messages, and I found it is the best way to share and my feelings with others.
It has an incredible, it has a rhythm and a force and an urgency combined with your astonishingly powerful lyrics. I think you have found your medium to communicate. So you just mentioned the dream book, and we were talking before, and you said that it was something you found as you were studying, that there was an incredible woman, there often are incredible women in these stories, an incredible woman who helped you to see what your dreams were. And she used a technique called the dream book. Should we just see the clip and see if that helps explain?
میخوام کنسرتی که برگزار میکنم همینقدر تماشاچی داشته باشه همینقدر خوشم بکشن اینم خودم هم عکس یکم کوچیکه بابا باز شروع شد بچه 200 تومن همین که امروزم به اگذر خوش به حال من تو خودت ناامیدی میخوای امید بدی به من من پول نمیخوام میدونم چیه سهم من تو چی میدونی آخه از سرنوشت من من فردام روشنه نخو غم من Thank you. Did you see my fans?
Yeah.
5 or 8.
That's fine. But they're super fans. They love you.
A few days ago, I went to Lincoln Center. I performed for 3,000 people.
It's wonderful, and that dream book where you think about what you want and you make a picture of it and you work for it, even though you're singing into a spoon because you're working in the kitchen, you have been to Lincoln Center and you have been doing extraordinary things since that video went viral and people saw it and they brought you to the States to study, which is where you now are. And you are also, while studying, you are also going around. You were at the State Department, you've been mingling with vice presidents and first ladies and secretaries of state to get this message out about child marriage. So can you just tell us, we have just a couple of minutes left, just tell us what you want us to see. If you were going to make a new page in your dream book about child marriage, what would you have in there? What do you want to do?
What do I want to do?
Mm-hmm. What do you want to do to end child marriage?
Oh, how do I want to end? So, mm-hmm. My solution to end child marriage is to work with families because, as I say, they don't know other ways. And we need to work with religion leaders because they can help us to get in communities and work with families. And we also need to support girls to see there are other possibilities for themselves and they can believe in themselves. And organizations and governments, we need them to support this kind of programs that are working to end child marriage. And laws, we need laws to make child marriage illegal. And
mm-hmm.
thank you.
And what happens to you, I was saying the other day that trying to catch up with Sunita to talk to her, I couldn't because she was in DC at the State Department, and then I couldn't because she was at Lincoln Center performing. And then I tried the other night, but she couldn't come to dinner because she was doing her geometry homework. Why, just tell me very briefly, why do you like geometry?
Oh, I love geometry because I love solving problems, and also I like geometry because sometimes you don't need to talk that much in a class. It's just numbers. And
so solving problems and not talking very much. Just to end this session, in a way, to go back to the refugee point, when you were in Iran, you were writing songs to express your feelings about things, and child marriage was very important to you, but also your home, Afghanistan, was very important to you. Tell me about another song that you wrote when you were in Iran, about home.
I wrote a song called War. It is about, because I lost my childhood in war in Afghanistan, and the same thing is happening to children all over the world, and you can see how many refugees are there. And some people ask me, do you like America or Afghanistan? It is clear, I love Afghanistan, because it is my home, it is the place where my heart is happy, and I'm in America because the war has taken all opportunities from me, from others, and I'm here to learn more and to go back, help others with what I learned and how I can help them.
And it's so important as an artist and as an activist that you're able to express yourself and the stories of others through your art. Would you have any interest in hearing another song from Sunita? Thank you for talking to me, finally. If we could maybe get some nice young men to move the furniture, perhaps you could sing for us War.
Sure, thank you.